Double check.
Check, check, check.
Yep.
Good evening.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We are live at Clarksdale, Mississippi for the eighth grade game, if you caught us early.
Flowers around the end there on the left side for the B team game. Y'all excuse us, we are looking right into the sun.
Flowers on the carry for Bayou.
I mean directly into the sun. You're never supposed to look directly into the sun, but that's exactly what we're doing. Joey Mallett, Todd Jeffries live from Lee Academy, where your Bayou Academy Colts are battling the Lee Academy Colts today, Todd.
Yeah, it looks like, Joey, we're going to have an abbreviated B game. I think we're just going to have one 20-minute half, and that's going to be it. And then we're going to roll right into our A game around 6:30 or so is what we were told.
Okay. All right. So that gives you an update. We're going to play 20 minutes of this game. Here comes Parker George around the end, finds a little seam, bounces out. Parker George, a great little runner, and he picks up about 5 yards on the play. As Todd said, we played the fifth grade game and a sixth grade game, and we're going to play abbreviated eighth grade game, and then we're going to move up to the main event, which is our Bayou Academy ninth graders. It's going to be the last game of the year, so hey, if you're interested in football, we'd love to have you with us this afternoon. Todd Jeffries and Joey Mallett are going to be right here bringing it to you live. You're going to get a free ride, no charge, not a dime.
You know, there's Parker George. He may be
touchdown.
Going to the house.
Parker George.
Flag on the play. Flag.
Touchdown.
Old Yeller, Joey.
Old Yeller is down on the field. Parker George made a great cut to the sideline.
Holding on by
the Academy. Nobody was there. As Todd Jeffries has pointed out, the yellow flag
is on the
ground. And indeed, it is holding on your Bayou Academy coach. Todd, that's going to be about a 50-yard penalty when you add up that he trotted it in from 40 yards out.
Yeah. You know, you mentioned all the games being played this afternoon. All these young men, young boys, probably know one another to a large extent playing baseball or basketball together. We're only 30, 35 minutes away from each other. Most of these young guys know each other. A lot of the parents know one another. We always get a warm welcome when we're here at Lee Academy. So it's good to get together, and we're here for the final junior high game of the year. Rashard, long pass, incomplete.
Receiver
needed to come back to that ball, Joey.
He looked like he had a shot at it, but it died down and landed towards his feet, so got to work on that a little bit. But you're right, Todd, all these kids know each other. They play basketball, football, track, and it's always interesting to come out. A lot of the rivals get heated up, and you think they're really angry at each other. Football's a pretty violent sport, and it's right in your face, you know. And a lot of times you think the kids are mad, but they're just getting that adrenaline up for the game. And after the game, they're taking pictures and smiling, laughing, texting each other after. So it's like with Washington School, Greenwood. They're all 35, 45 minutes apart. And it's
That's
a good rivalry. Good competition
in
all areas, north, south, east, or west.
Flowers went around the left side on third down, so we've got fourth and one.
Be fourth and one for Bayou.
And you're going to hear the Lee Academy announcer because his microphone is right above us, so we may overlap at times.
Well, they got great music playing here. We got a good football game going on.
Triangle. Joey and I are going to see if we can move and see if we can pick.
That was incomplete.
I don't think it really matters, Joey. The announcers got a good strong voice and a loud microphone.
That's it. He's going to be heard across this field tonight. We hope that you are sitting in wait on this Bayou Academy Colt clash. We are playing the District 4
First and 10, Lee Academy.
Tonight.
Well, I'm just going to let this PA announcer announce the down and distance.
Yeah, he can do the down and distance. We've got to try to talk over him. That's not going to be possible, it doesn't seem like.
I am anxiously awaiting for the sun to get down below the trees, Joseph.
How do you like the way they got this football field positioned? It's like you're at your hunting camp, and you woke up the next morning, somebody put a football field right out in the middle of your hunting camp.
Pass passing the ball. Lee
tailback
Academy.
Pass.
Oh, two men got a hold of it and didn't correct.
Pass was incomplete.
You know, that play's usually open. They pitch it back to that tailback, get that defense to bite, and they try to tailback pass it right over the top of the defense, and it was almost successful there. Big crew over here on the sideline as I'm watching the ninth grade crew for Lee Academy coach warm up. They've got some good size linemen, number 55 we're familiar with. That's Jonathan Redwine, O'Shawn Redwine's son. He's a coach from up there around Lee, always putting his time in with the youth. Big shout out to O'Shawn Redwine. Good grind, good move for the Colt runner. That is a Lee Colt runner.
That's number 5, Jackson Lively on the carry for Lee Academy. He's brought down by number 52, Rylan Richards.
So we're just going to let this
PA. 52, I'm sorry, Crawford Laster.
Yeah, let him kind of give you the down and distance, and then Joey and I will pipe in.
Yeah, we're getting our bearings over here.
Yeah.
Last game of the year. You're in a treat for the night, folks. The Bayou Academy Colts have come out slugging like they have every year for 3 years in a row. We have a record of 19-5 on the three-year
run. Number 5, Jackson Lively on the carry for
Lee
Academy.
It's not bad for your Bayou Academy Colts, Todd. 19-5 record is pretty good.
He said over the last 3 years.
3 years, including this
year. Brought down by number 66, Braxton
Ray. The grade JV team, right.
You'll remember, though, 2 years ago, the district champion Bayou Colts
beat 4-3 Lee Academy.
Upset by Lee Academy late in the year, left a real bad taste.
That is correct. I had actually not thought about that until you just mentioned it. And Todd is exactly right. They brought up a real speedy team. Good quarterback, couple good running backs.
Number 15, Mac Ferrassi on the carry.
We were caught off
guard,
and the Bayou Academy Colts did not fare well in that one.
So last year, they came to Bayou.
Be 1st and 10, Bayou Academy.
Gave us another scare. Eventually, we pulled away in that game. But look, this is Lee Academy. They are 4A district champions in JV. So they're going to bring it. And
when you've got the title of a 4A district champion, your football team has to be pretty good no matter how you cut the cake. And I've heard rumors on number one for the Lee Academy coach that he is very speedy. He's number one running back in 4A district. So
there's
you're going to have your hands full with him tonight.
Yeah, so he's actually.
That's number 6, Parker George on the carry for Bayou.
Receiver.
Broke down by number 8.
They get him the ball.
Leighton Marley.
And, you know, in space.
In space.
George runs for, I believe, a first down.
Be 1st and 10, Bayou Academy.
Well, Todd and I are sitting up high in the pigeon's nest, and that sun is blaring right in our eyes, so it's hard to pick up the numbers. That's why we're not calling out the numbers as readily as we have been in the past tonight. But that sun is settling behind the trees, and we're going to start shouting out these Bayou Academy Colt names. Are they driving the ball down the field? Here comes a pass to number 27. I don't have a number
on
him, Todd.
Grayson Grubb.
Grayson Grubb on a good catch and a spin. He won't get much, but he made a good catch.
Grayson Grubb on reception for Bayou. Brought down by number 67, Cason Banger.
Number 27, old Grubb, he was just a bubble screen. He
the
made a good catch.
Second and 10 Bayou Academy.
He couldn't wiggle.
We're already about halfway through this B game, so it's going by quick. Probably the team that scores is going to win this game. That's a high snap. Rashard's got it.
Smart on Rashard, number 7. He's going to be close to that first down, second down, and maybe inches. It was a high snap.
Rashard on the carry for Bayou.
Gets on his vertical leap and reaches up and pulls it down with one hand, and he sprints around the left side. Oh, Rylan Rashard, number 7. Keep an eye on him.
Stop by number 18.
Upcoming quarterback for your Bayou Academy Colts.
You can tell this Lee Academy team, good fundamental tacklers, so we should expect that in the next game, too.
Hey, they're not light on size. They didn't win the district for nothing. They've got some talent down there on that field, and they're going to bring it tonight. Rashard makes a good cut. shifty. He moves away from two would-be tacklers, and he races out of bounds for a Bayou Academy.
That's number seven,
first
Rylan
down.
Richard on the carry. Stopped by number five, Jackson Lively.
Todd and I may have to have a little higher octave tonight. As he's mentioned, the speaker is right over the booth, and the PA announcer is doing a fantastic job. And so we may be running into some communication problems as it goes along. So the Bayou Academy Colts are threatening to score. They are inside the 15-yard line. Here we go, another high snap. Rylan Richard pulls it down. He makes a good stiff arm, and he's going to get a couple on the play, Todd.
See, I mean, they're just right there. That was a good tackle.
That's number seven, Rylan Richard, again on the carry for Bayou. Stopped by number five, Jackson Lively.
Get some other teams this year, B teams. You see Richard break that tackle, but that young man came up and made a good form tackle on him.
Yeah, I agree with you. The Bayou Academy Colts were making good blocks, but the Lee defender comes off the block, and he is right there to make the tackle. That is just good form tackling, good fundamental, good structure for Lee Academy. Shotgun formation, Parker George, number six at the tailback position. Rylan Richard calls a man in motion. He gives it to Cooper Flowers, number 26. He makes a spin move, and this one's going anywhere. He's going to be lucky if he gets up from this one. It looked like he may have
That's
hurt his leg.
Number 26, Cooper Flowers on the carry. Stopped by
Thankfully,
number eight,
he gets up. He's
Leighton Marley.
Yeah, but that leg got caught up under him, Todd, as he made a spin, and he was hit pretty hard. He'll have to come off the field.
I'm not sure if Flowers
was
hurt.
The third and eight for Bayou Academy.
Before the tackle, because he did look a little indecisive and kind of checked up all of a sudden.
Well, it looks like he ran a little bit too far towards the sideline, and instead of cutting up into traffic, he would have been better served to cut up there. But that leg got caught up under him, and he's sidelined for the time being. We'll keep a check on that. Shotgun formation, third down and seven. He gives it to Parker George. Nifty run right there. Parker's going to go for about 5 yards. That's going to put him within manageable
spot. Number eight, Brandon
spot.
Parker on the carry for Bayou. Stopped by number eight, Leighton Marley.
After a Parker George run.
We got 7 minutes left, so this thing is flying.
Be fourth and two for Bayou.
Fourth and two could be the game for Bayou. As we've said earlier, it's going to be a short version, 20-minute game with 7 minutes left in the game.
You can see on your video the mostly ninth grader group is now coming out for Bayou. Maybe a little bit of a show of force, but of course you got to back that up.
You got to back it up every week, and they've done so for 3 years. So Bayou Academy, here comes
George.
Parker George. He's going to dance into the end zone.
Touchdown.
Touchdown, Parker George.
Touchdown,
all right,
number
Parker
eight,
George,
Brandon
Todd.
Crocker.
He is a well-built athlete. I mean, he doesn't have an ounce of fat on him anywhere. He's real solid. His core strength is good. His leg strength is good. And he's a smart runner. As you can see, his vision on the field, he can see a hole and then all of a sudden turn. We think, where is he going? And there's another hole. So he's got good vision. He's got a lot of attributes going on for him. Parker George, good running back.
Good player. In fact, he played a big role in the game last week, Joe. You weren't with us, was injured at one point in the A game. I don't believe came back in, and I believe was kind of touch and go this week about whether he was going to suit up. So glad to see him out there.
Trips to the left, going for the two-point conversion. Richard keeping it himself. He may have got in, and he does get in just by the nose of the football.
Is good. That was number seven.
Two-point
conversion. Richard.
Good for Bayou Academy. 8-0 lead, Todd, as this game's going to wind down. 5 minutes and 36 seconds. Lee's going to have to get on their horse and run it in if they expect to stay in this one. Todd Jeffries, Joey Mallett, bringing you Bayou Academy football live from Lee Academy Football Complex. 8-0 is your score.
5 minutes to go.
Bayou Academy on top. That's the way we like it, Todd. Bayou Academy has been on top this year in a lot of games. We've had some good struggles. That's eighth grade and ninth grade. But in the ninth grade in particular, you know, we started out at Hartfield and had, you know, they're the 6A champ. And then we played, the only other loss we had on the whole schedule was Starkville, and they happened to be the 5A champ. So Bayou Academy is trying to end up their year 6-2. on the year, which will be a fantastic year in anybody's book, and we're here to see it live.
Number 8, Leighton Marley on the carry for Lee Academy. Stopped by number 6, Parker George, but there's a flag on the play.
In fact, last week, Bayou was down 12-7 to Washington.
False start, Lee Academy.
Late in the third quarter and had two scores to kind of take control of that game. Had a good defensive stop, but Washington gave us all we could ask for.
I listened to the game as you broadcast it, and you forementioned that in the Starkville game, we jumped up to a 7-0 lead, and that you said you got to be careful. You know, it could dissipate like it did at Starkville, and it indeed did. It went to 12-7 before the Bayou Academy Colts bounced back.
And you remember
won the game.
We did the we jumped out.
That's
world.
Number 15, Mac Ferrassi on the carry for Lee Academy. Stopped by number 7, Rylan Richard.
We jumped out to a big lead on Mac Heights.
Second and 22, Lee Academy.
So at this age, I'm just not comfortable with any league, Joseph.
Well, it's in the nature of the beast. The football field is a tough, rough place to be. If you haven't been down on the field level, listen to the growling, the blood, the sweat.
One ball, I think Bayou's going to try to go to the
that
house.
That is William Garrett in for the touchdown for the Bayou Academy Colts. Big William Garrett, number 57.
Number 57,
they
William
made a
Garrett
lick.
On the touchdown for Bayou.
The ball came loose, and Johnny on the spot was number 57, William Garrett. Todd, he raced into the end zone. Look at the excitement on the Bayou Academy Colts.
Sometimes those defenders get that ball, and they don't know what to do with it. William Garrett knew exactly what to do with it, and that was to take it to the house.
Yes, indeed.
Good job, William Garrett.
Hey, when you're down in those trenches, those fumbles like that don't come. They come very few and very unoften. But let me tell you something. It was there. He picked it up and scooped 6 into the end zone, extending that lead out to 14-0 in favor of your Bayou Academy Colts. Couple men coming on and off the field, directed by Coach Will Reed. Here it's going to be a pass. Oh, good catch. Number 10. I don't know who that is.
Kale Hawford.
Oh, that is Kale Hawford.
Number
great 10, catch.
Kale
number
Hawford.
10. Kale Hawford.
He is good.
He goes out and does a curl route right into the end zone. The ball was fired right on the money, and Kale made a fantastic catch.
I wonder if that was Ford Murphy who threw him the ball, whether we had a predominantly seventh grade group in there. Not sure.
I believe that was the two-point conversion. So it should be 16-0 in favor of your Bayou Academy Colts.
So it does look like we're coming out in with 1:20 to go. We're coming out with a predominantly seventh grade group, which is good for these young men to get this experience.
Well, I love the music. I love the festivities. And look at that Bayou blue across the way there, Todd. We brought a whole slew of Cleveland residents to watch this one. I see the cheerleaders cheering in the distance. The parents are clapping in the stand. That's good to see. Fun festivities in this kind of weather of October. You can't ask for anything better than this. The kids are playing in the background. The parents are here for this last ball game.
That's number 5.
And
Jackson Lively on the carry for Lee Academy.
It looks like we're going to wind this one down. This is going to go quick, Todd. 40 seconds left in the ball game. 14-0. Bayou Academy Colts.
And on the stop was number 35, Tristan Vasquez.
Lee Academy quickly lining up. They've got maybe one play left. Here he comes. It's a pitch out. It's a pitch and throw.
Throw it.
It's a bomb. He's got a man. He's got a reception.
He's going to score.
He is going to score. What a pass play. Lee Academy runs the old trick again.
Lee Academy, number 8, Leighton Marley.
Shame on you. Fool me twice. Shame on me. Big play, 65 yards. Touchdown as the horn blows. They're going to give them the 6 points, but it's not going to be enough to overcome the powerful Bayou Academy Colts, and they've mounted a 14-6 lead.
Lee's going to get a chance here to put a two more on the board.
Man, I can see it in the face of the Lee Academy coaches. Hey, guys, give us another 20 minutes. I think we can stay in this one. But unfortunately for them, for the eighth grade, that's going to be it. He's going for the 2 points, and he's not going to get it. Well, no, he is short. Final score, Bayou Academy Colts 14, Lee Academy Colts 6.
So we'll take a break, folks, but we're set to start at 6:30, so stay with us. We'll be back in a few minutes for the start of the JBA game.
You got 10 minutes, folks. Get all your stuff situated and head back up. Listen to the Bayou Academy football.
ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Lee Academy, home of your Lee Academy coach. The MAIS recognizes that the spirit of the game of football lives in skilled offense, effective defense, and a well-planned strategy. The spirit of this game cannot be maintained unless sportsmanship, ethics, and integrity are our number one priority. Good sportsmanship will be expected from all groups associated with MIS activities.
We've heard that statement before, Joseph. We got some captains on the field: William Jeffries, Mitchell Jones, Aiden Borganelli, I believe, and I'm trying to see who the
captains for Lee Academy.
Trey Pruitt.
Are number three, Ray Nantisi, number 20 is Peyton Burton, number 10, Sawyer Humber, the Saw Dog. Number 2, Colby Gibbons. And number 26, Bryant Johnson.
Lee has won the toss and has deferred, Joey, so we're going to get the ball.
Captains for Bayou are number 16, Ethan Lamb.
No.
Number 3 is William Jeffries. And number 2 is Aiden Borganelli.
I hope he...
And number 24, Trey Pruitt.
He said Ethan Lamb, but it was Mitchell Jones.
It was Mitchell Jones, big number 15. Todd, I'm so excited about this game. It's the last game of the season, and Bayou Academy needs to come out and make a statement. They are playing the Division 4A district champions in the form of a Lee.
So Lee won their district. Bayou has secured second in District 5 North. So this game is for bragging rights, it's for pride, and it's to finish the season. Both teams want to end on a good note. I don't think, I can promise you, Bayou Academy is not taking Lee Academy lightly.
You can believe it. That adrenaline's going to be up tonight. The ninth graders know it's their last game for both teams. And we're looking for a clash of the Titans. Bayou Academy, if you don't know it already, have already played the District 6 champions, the District 5 champions, and now they're playing the District 4 champions. So they've had a great season, your Bayou Academy Colts. They also, don't forget, we had a big game against Mag Heights here not too long ago, and you know the young man that was drafted by the Ole Miss Rebels, because I know you're an Ole Miss Rebel fan. What was the guy's name, the quarterback?
Cole Prosack. He's committed to Ole Miss baseball.
Cole Prosack. And old Prosack, he did all he could against the Colts, tried to make a late comeback, but old Bayou Academy Colts hung in there, and that was a great win for the Colts this year.
Absolutely. That, along with that Heritage win on the road.
Oh, man, what a win down in Heritage if you weren't there. That was a fantastic ball game, hard-fought ball game, and your coach came out victorious there. We also put a slam down on the Washington Generals last week.
Would everyone please stand for the prayer?
We're going to pause for the prayer and the national anthem.
Now, gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day, Lord. Thank you for these parents and grandparents that come out and support these kids. Watch over both teams and have everyone have safe travel home. I pray this in Jesus' holy name. Amen.
Jeffries, Joey Mallett for Bayou Academy football. We got Coach Norwood high in the pigeon's nest. He's going to be calling the plays from up top side. He's done a fantastic job all year long.
I'm going to check to see if he'd rather have our spot. Bear with me.
The game. Who is the head coach in charge?
This kickoff is sponsored by Multi Oak Property, your local land expert.
Bayou Academy Colt or the Lee Colt? We're going to see who's a true Colt tonight.
So, that's number 7, Noah Finley, kicking off the Lee Academy.
Just like every game, Joey, we want to start off clean, have a good drive, and get this game off
that
on the right track.
Yes, indeed.
Number 1, Bo Lucas, and
here
number 2,
we go, baby.
Aiden Borganelli.
We didn't come down here to play. We came down to cut up sideways. The Cleveland team is hot and heavy, and we aim to win this ball game.
Bo Lincas is back in the lineup tonight, and he's got the ball.
Here comes Bo. He's shooting for the sideline, Todd. He looked like a gazelle out there. Did you see the long strides as he hit that hole, and he's going to bounce it up around the 34-yard line. Pretty good run for Bo Lincas.
Number 1, Bo Lincas on the carry for
He was out last week, Todd. I know he had an injury. Do you know anything about the injury?
It was some sort of knee injury. I don't know the details. He wasn't moving around well, so they held him out. We were able to get the win without him, but I can promise you we missed him at times.
Yes, indeed.
On the defensive side of the ball.
Oh, yeah, he's a great wingman over there and linebacker on defense. Here we go, Mitchell Jones in the shotgun formation. Ryan Dawson Mallett. And they hand it to Ryan Dawson Mallett. He makes a turn. He's breaking down the sideline. They give him the ball, and he rambles and rumbles. And big Ryan Dawson Mallett rumbles for about 20 yards on the first carry of the game. Todd, we haven't seen that all year.
Well,
but they give big Mallett the ball. I guess they're trying to switch the handoff up to fool that cold defense, the lead defense, because normally we'd give it start off maybe with Aiden Borganelli.
First and 10, Bayou Academy.
Most informed folks would have probably thought there was a 95% chance Aiden was going to get the ball, and so you mix it up a little bit. And
well, good run for number 33.
Absolutely.
Ryan Dawson Mallett.
Broke some tackles right at the line of scrimmage.
Now feed Aiden Borganelli. There it comes. Back to back. That's what we like.
That's number 2, Aiden Borganelli on
Six
the carry
yard
for
gain on the play. Not
five.
Bad for a first down
number
play
Number 1, Desi Monick.
Like we saw in the B game, we've got this team outsized, but just watch.
Number 20, Peyton Burton.
Watch Lee Academy. They tackle well.
Good solid team. Like you said, good fundamental, good form tackling. They got some speed in the backfield. As we mentioned earlier, number 1 is their safety, and he is a speed burner. Keep an eye on him, guys.
He's going to be a big part of both sides of the ball, defense and offense.
Kellen Allen out wide to the right, along with Bo Lincas. Brandon Crocker will head up on the left side as wide receiver. And Mitchell Jones is in the shotgun formation. Penalty on the play.
Flag on the play.
Looked like maybe a delay of game. And it is. Clock had
expired. Delay of game, Bayou Academy.
5 yards back. That's going to erase Aiden Borganelli's run.
So, yeah, each game, you find out how the play clock's going to be kept. And usually they give a warning. They may have there, and it just went unheeded.
A big line for Bayou Academy has done a tremendous job this year at center, number 63, Anderson Short. And here comes the snap. Give it to Aiden Borganelli.
Right side, he's got the
room. Got his jets moving. He may score. He's got out one run man, and it's their speedster. Can he do it? Big flag. Way in the backfield.
Aiden Borganelli on the
carry. It's going towards.
Stopped by number 14, Graydon Burke.
It's causing holding, and it looks like it's on number 74.
Blocked in the back against Bayou Academy.
Danny Griffith's stepson.
Let's see how that affects.
I see Danny. I can tell him he's done turned 3 shades of red right there.
They're going to call it at the 25. Okay, so it's going to be a first down.
Yeah, after the first down was gained. First down, Bayou Academy.
So we may be
That's
dealing.
Big Hill Lasker.
We may be dealing with old Yaller tonight.
We will. Well, they're quick to throw that flag tonight, as you've seen, Todd. And we've seen this before, especially over in Hartfield, our first game of the year.
And Heritage, too.
out at wide receiver now. In comes William Jeffries, number three, out wide to the left. Aiden Borgnelli in the backfield. Here comes Bo Linkus. It's popped. Oh, it's fumbled. It's a fumble. Somebody's got a jump on it, and it looks like Lee Academy. They came up with the pigskin. I cannot believe it. All of a sudden, the ball was like delayed in the air, and Bow never got control of it.
It was a forward pass, though, Joey. It was a forward pass. That's what we're trying to tell him. That's why we run that pitch to the forward. It's not a fumble if he never.
It is considered a pass play. You're exactly right.
These referees
should be an incomplete pass.
Are not paying attention to the fact that was a pass. And we do that for a reason, so that if we have a play like that, it is considered an incomplete.
And Rodney Martin is in the referee's ear, but the referee is having nothing to do with it. And I'm like Todd, it was an incomplete pass, but it's going to be considered a turnover. And here comes
Desi.
He's trying to get to the corner. He's to the corner. He's got one man to beat, and it's Aiden Borgnelli.
Number one, Desi.
First down.
Lee Academy.
Aiden Borgnelli got a hold to him like a bulldog and drug him down to the turf.
Got a hold on Lee.
In the back, Lee Academy.
I'm going to tell you what. The referees just need to let the kids play the game. Them flags are flying. That's about the fourth flag in three plays. I don't know. But look,
you know, I think
hard physical game that you got here. A lot of talk on the field. They're getting some signals from the sideline.
So Coach Martin, Coach Norwood, they're going to have a talk with these officials about how we run that sweep play and that it's a forward pass.
Well, you saw the speed of that running back now. We can't let him get the edge. Listen, they're going right back to him, I guarantee it. There he is.
On the right side.
Mallet right in, and two big linemen. Number 62, that's Bryce Clark.
Number
70, that's Corey Barfield. And number 72, Griffin Peoples. Todd, we've got a great line. We've mentioned them all year.
Lee Academy.
And we like to give them their props. As you know, we have done that all year. They play defense and offense. And let me tell you, they're well-conditioned athletes.
So Desi Monix, they call him D1. He's a good athlete back there for Lee Academy. And he's going to probably get 30 carries tonight if they can get it.
D1 money.
There's the quarterback.
A little spin. He's got a seam. Good job by Bo Linkus and number 62,
Brady Antici on the carry. Stopped by number one, Bo Linkus.
Third and seven for Lee. I think they're kind of, figuring out they're going to try to exploit us on the outside. I think we're too big on the inside to run up.
So far, we've hung in there. It's a big play. We need to get a quick three and out, Todd, and get that football back. Here comes Mallet from the outside. Oh, 70.
70.
That is Corey Barfield. Old corkscrew Corey comes through and puts his helmet right in the sternum of number one. What a tackle, Todd. How about that form tackle?
Great tackle by Barfield.
Number one, Desi Monix on the carry, brought down by number 70.
Well, surely they will punt at this point. It's
Corey
down and eight.
Fourth and seven.
Great play for number 70, Corey Barfield. I know Danny Barfield is a proud grandfather after that play.
Watch out for a little fake. Just be on that alert.
A little trickery, but they're too deep in their territory, it would seem. Almost blocked. They're going to let this one bounce and come to a halt around the 42-yard line of the Colts of Bayou.
4 minutes and 3 seconds to go. Joey.
The first and 10, Bayou Academy.
I know we feel like we didn't get the right call there, but it still was a ball that we didn't control and kind of rolled around. So even though it was an incomplete pass, we need to clean it up and kind of gather ourselves. And
well, I saw Coach Flip and Coach Norwood conversing, well as Coach Reed, and I'm sure they'll get that cleaned up. Landon Williams been solid all year out here at wide receiver, number 14. Given to Borgnelli. Borgnelli's got a seam. And look out. Borgnelli's going to turn on the Jets. One man to beat. Mallet.
Watch for those flags, Joey. Watch
for
those flags.
Borgnelli. Touchdown, Bayou Academy.
Borgnelli.
You get used to looking for old Yeller.
Oh, Bayou Academy Colts. They turn to their number one Colt, Aiden Borgnelli. And Todd, as you have seen him do time and time again this year, he burst out for about a 60-yard run.
So this is our eighth game, Joey. I'm just going to guess that Morganelli, through seven games, had somewhere in the area of 1,200 yards rushing.
I would agree with that. I would agree with that. And he's going to break 1,500 if he keeps running like this today. Landon Williams with the hold. Kellen
just
Allen with
got
the
it
kick.
Through. Good job. No, that ball was.
PAT is no good.
That ball was over the.
It looked over to me, but hey, Todd and I have disagreed with each yellow flag, and now we're disagreeing with the extra point. But listen, let's just give credit where credit's due. We didn't go to umpire school. So I'm going to tell you that the umpires trump us, overrule, no good, 6-0 for the Bayou Academy Colts. Happy to take that lead as Aiden Morganelli trotted to 60 yards for a touchdown, and the Bayou Academy Colts are right back on top of it. They've got the music playing. They got the festivities going, and our crowd from Cleveland, Mississippi has followed. Todd, this is what I've been expecting. You can see a lot of energy on that field. Both teams are hitting and hitting hard. I like this kind of atmosphere. Speaking of hitting and hitting hard, how about those Ole Miss Rebels jumping off to a 5-0 start?
6-0.
6-0. Oh, I missed a game. 6-0 start, and then your old Bulldogs pulling up the rear. 5-1.
Both
that
teams.
Is heading to be the old Egg Bowl is going to be a clash of the Titans again this year. Happy to have you with us, Todd Jeffries, Joey Mallett from Lee Field, as your Bayou Academy Colts are winning this one.
Kick out of bounds,
6-0. Todd, as we've mentioned, the Bayou Academy Colts have had a great year this year. They're trying to get
to
6-2.
Lee Academy.
They beat the likes of Mag Heights, Washington School, North Delta. They beat Heritage, as you mentioned earlier.
Pillow.
And they beat we beat Pillow, of course. Don't leave them out. So, look, if you want to know about your Bayou Academy Colts, just listen to what I just said. 6 wins, 6 big wins on the year, 19-5 in the last 3 years. So,
but you need to keep track
of those Colts.
That's great. But I tell you, Lee Academy doesn't care about that right now.
No.
Desi Monix doesn't. He's
D1.
Number one. He's going to try to get to the house.
If you're watching that TV screen, look right in the middle of your screen. Tailback for the Lee Academy Colts is something to watch. They call him D1 Money. They give it to D1 Money. He's looking for an outside. He gets pinned over there. I can't see who made the play, but they popped him. You can hear the leather.
That's number one, Desi Monix over there. The carry for Lee Academy.
And old D1, he got a taste of that Bayou Academy Colt defense.
Bayou Academy tackle.
Bayou Academy Colts, they're hyped up tonight. They know it's their last game. And, buddy, it's going to be a slugfest where everybody else is out back laughing and joking. Bayou Academy Colts have been up front, so cooking and smoking.
I look for Lee to run to the wide side of the field here. Let's see if they do it.
Well, let's check it out.
That's the near side of the field on your screen.
Mallett looks like he's in a blitz formation on the short side of the field. And indeed he is. And Todd called it. If he would have bounced out, he had a little seam. They're going to drag him down, but not before he could pick up the first down. Did you see how quick the first
one? Number one, Desi Monix on the carry for Lee.
We had him pinned, Todd, and he spun and he hit a hole and he's got leg drive. And he basically just leg drive that first down. That's going to be first and 10 for your Lee
Academy coach.
He's a player that when you watch as an opponent, he just makes you uncomfortable. He's making me uncomfortable right now, Joseph.
Well, we've moved Eason Lamb over here. He's coming on the outside from this side. This is dead up the middle, and a great play. Number 63, Anderson Short. Anderson is real good at that. Last week, he had Jonesy Robinson, and they were running the wishbone. And he made that play time and time again. And tonight is no different. They tried to hit it to the quick man, but Anderson Short sniffed it out, and down he goes. Good play. Second down 10 for the Lee Academy Colts. I like having Bo Linkus back. He's a major player at linebacker. Let's see if he can make a play. We need one now.
Monix.
They give it to D1
ball.
Again. Number 62, Bryce Clark has him. But look at the leg drive. That's what we were talking about earlier. He's going to wear it down, but he's not going to wear it down quickly. Todd, we had him back. He had only gained 1 yard, and he pulled the pile 8 yards
Third down and two.
Well, stopped at the line of scrimmage.
I mean, you remember guys like Roger Craig from San Francisco 49ers when they had that high leg drive. Walter Payton had the high leg drive.
Be third.
Barry Sanders had the high leg drive. Well, I know those guys, but this guy has a high leg drive. And here comes the spin run, and he's got move. He's got a lane. Good run. Oh, no. It's just incidental contact. The Lee faithful were hollering for the out-of-bounds. He had an unnecessary roughness, but what did you think?
Yeah, by number one, Bo Lucas.
He hit him out-of-bounds, but there wasn't any ill intent there. You know, so Antisi, and we know him from other sports, he kind of drops back like he's about to pass, and then he cuts him
out.
It's a little deceptive, and we've got to try to identify.
We're covering the receivers. He's letting those receivers run down the field, and as he spins, there's a big lane, and he's hit it twice tonight. Right back to your number one, and he's got one man to beat. That was a great tackle by Eason Lamb,
number 16,
or he would have been gone. Eason Lamb got low. He put that shoulder pad into his hip and drove his feet off the ground and down to the turf. First down, good play for Eason Lamb. Our defense have been pretty steady all year long. They've been, but don't break.
First and 10, Lee Academy.
6-0 lead the Bayou Academy Colts are clinging to with a minute 55 left in the first quarter. And it's been a great ball game, as Todd pointed out earlier. This is the District 4 champions that you're watching live and in action tonight. Same spin to the opposite side. He's got a little lane. This time they're going to wrap him up. He's going to gain about four on
That's
the play.
Number three, Braden Antisi on the carry for the Colts.
It looks like William Jeffries got outside, cut him off on that outside run, got a piece of him. The rest of them came and cleaned it up.
Well, they gave old D1.
Stop by number one, Bo Lucas.
I believe you're fixing to get another handoff to D1.
They don't have to give D1 a breather.
Oh, I mean, yeah.
You know, he can't carry the ball. I mean, you can tell he's tired, but he'll –
carrying the pile like that takes a lot of energy. And he's a young man, only a ninth grader. Bam. Fakes it. He's looking to throw it. He throws it. He's got a target, and the ball is dropped. Good
pass
coverage.
Is incomplete.
Landon Williams on the coverage, number 14. He comes in and drives the receiver to the turf. Great play for Landon Williams. Todd, he should have made
play,
the catch.
Number 14,
the
Landon
ball was
Williams.
Just sprung loose.
Yeah. Lee has got the ball at our 25, third down and 8, but they're in two down territory, no doubt about it.
Absolutely. And as you can see so far, Lee has earned the right to be the 4A champion. They're no slouch. They're playing Bayou Academy tooth and nail. Down by 6. Here comes the play. It's given to their money man, and D Money goes down this time. Fourth down and about 6. So this is good position.
Number one, Andy Money's on the carry. Tackled by a host of Bayou Academy.
Do you see a misdirection here? Do you see a pass? I don't
think. Be fourth and 8, Lee Academy.
You can run just your straight play. But Monix is, you know, as we've seen a lot like Borganelli, sometimes just a simple handoff and he can do the rest.
You know, that's kind of what I see. If I'm them, I'm giving it to my best man on 8 yards. So I would roll out and pitch the ball to him. We'll see what he does. It is a rollout. You called it. He looks deep. He's got a man.
Wide open. Flag on the play. I'm not sure what the flag is.
Touchdown, Lee Academy. Number 7, Noah Lindley.
Two flags on the play.
Two flags on the play.
Let's see if we had a
line of scrimmage.
Hold on the offense. I don't know.
Hold on. Wait a minute. The Zebras are talking. The head zebra in the white hat will make the call. They're going over it and discussing, as Todd Jeffries has pointed out. You are watching Bayou Academy football right here on live stream.
You know, you've got two flags, so there shouldn't be an argument about whether there was a penalty. Somebody committed a penalty, either it was offense or defense. Call the penalty. There was a score on the play. Let's see if it was offsetting or whether it was illegal man downfield on the offense.
Well, that's
and
definitely
And then we got a
back.
Face mask on the defense, and that's going to offset if
face mask on Bayou, ineligible receiver for Lee Academy.
I believe that offsets, unless they do something funky here. And, you know, sometimes they walk one off and then they walk the other off, and you just don't know.
It's really offsetting penalty. You should just replay the down. It was a good play by Lee, good play choice. And as I've said, Lee is no slouch. As you can see, they're coming out slinging. They're not depending on the one guy like we thought. They've rolled out and the quarterback sneaks. They're throwing the ball down the field. They're being unpredictable.
So it's offset.
Good coaching job.
So whatever happened there.
Be 4th and 8, Lee Academy coach.
That guy was wide open, so somebody didn't have him, you know.
Well, he was an ineligible receiver is what it looks like.
You think the person who caught the ball was?
I think he was. Now they're running a 2 tight end set.
They're going to roll
fake
out.
Fake again. Oh, come on, get him. He gets it off.
Good defensive play there.
Flag on the play.
Boy, that referee let the Lee Academy faithful talk him into calling that penalty. That wasn't a penalty. That was a good defensive play.
I don't know why, but that ball, the jolt to the back came after the ball was passed.
Well, be 1st and 10, Lee Academy coach.
Let's don't get into an argument with the Zebras. We're going to let them call their game. But, Todd, I mean, we're watching it from up here. Maybe we just have bad angle. But that looked like the ball was passed. He got hit in the back. It's not a penalty. But we'll give him the penalty. First down, Lee at the Bayou Academy 11-yard line. And here comes their superstar.
Fumble on the play.
Number 3, quarterback. That may be the last play of the first quarter. Going to have to switch ends of the field. Lee lost 2 yards on that play. Second down and 12.
Just got a video of that point after attempt, and it was good, Joey. So,
absolutely. I couldn't see anything
wrong.
And I think when we go review this penalty, you're going to find out that ball was already passed before the ball.
Look, we've played in games where we got more than one opponent, so we just got to
stop the clock.
So then we need all 5 of y'all to sell us a roll to run the clock.
Well, how about that? Just like that, if you're watching from home, you are in for a treat. You got Aiden Borganelli running for the Bayou Academy Colts, and you got D1 Money running for the Lee Academy Colts, and it has been a run fest. Ball game has been hard fought. Ball game has been tough in the trenches. And both teams are doing their dead level best to win this ball game. Todd, I enjoyed the first quarter. Had too many penalties, of course. We get rid of the penalties and let these guys play. We're going to have us a good ball game unfold out of here. Last game of the year. So if you're home with us, enjoy the free ride. No charge from Todd Jeffries and Joey Mallett. It's your Bayou Academy football program. Todd, how about a big win for our high school last week over the Lee Academy Colts? John Howard Gilbert had a tremendous game along with several other players. Ward, Luke Ward, he had a pretty good game. He had a lot of interest in that Bayou Academy high school team, and they've developed and getting better and better over the year. And next year promises to be even a better football team than we've had this year.
Yeah, they're 4-4 right now. They go on the road to Starkville tomorrow night. That'll be a real test.
If they can win another game, you know, there's one spot left in the playoffs, and Bayou Academy could be the recipient of that spot. First down and 10. Our second down after the fumble. Todd Jeffries, Joey Mallett. It is beautiful football weather. I don't think you can dial it up any better than this, folks. Sun setting and the Bayou Academy defense. Timeout on the field for the Lee Academy Colts.
So you're going to go through all that. I know the Lee Academy coaches are frustrated they had to call a timeout. But maybe they did it for a reason. Maybe they wanted to see how Bayou came out. And
Lee Academy has been the recipient so far of 2 big plays. We fumbled the ball, and they were able to recover it, so they got a turnover on defense.
We dropped a pass that was called a fumble.
We
Well, we dropped the pass. It was called a fumble. They get the benefit of it. And then they get a big penalty on fourth down and eight where the ball was clearly past the receiver. And they get the 15-yard penalty anyway.
Any breaks, you got to come out and play a clean game, and that's what Bayou's got to do. And,
now, you're not playing a pushover now. Lee Academy has won every game. They are the district champions, and you're in a football game. And here comes their back. D1 money is coming with this football. No, he fakes it. He's running, and here comes it. They love this play with the quarterback. Good hard run by Easton Lamb. Ran him down from the backside. And let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, from Cleveland, Mississippi, number 16, Easton Lamb is having a game. He has a nose for the football, Todd. He's been around the runner on just about every play.
And TC looks hurt. Looks like he's got a little bit of a shoulder injury.
Well, I'm going to tell you what, that Easton Lamb, he had his ears pinned back, and he was coming, brother. He's made some good tackles on D1 money earlier in the game, and on that play right there, he ran the quarterback down from behind.
So look for Lee to probably run the ball with the quarterback being a little banged up right here. Nope, the quarterback.
Same play. Can he get outside? Oh! Oh, that is Bryce Clark, number 62.
No. Great Nantinke on the carry for the Colts.
Ty Jeffries tells me, correction. Number 16, Easton Lamb. Easton Lamb better be careful. He's looking to be the MVP of the defense tonight.
And TC is tired of seeing Easton Lamb. Do you see how Lamb went low and got that
tackle?
He
did. And here comes the quarterback. He's coming. They're going to say, hey, give it to D1.
Yeah, they may put him in a wildcat.
Fourth down and 13. I bet they try to get him on that edge, Todd. Fourth and 13. They're in a must-go situation. D-Money is clapping his hands together. He seems excited. I guarantee you he's coming. They got the big fullback in front of him now. I formation. Two tight ends. Man in motion. Bam, here it comes. A fake to D-Money. It's going to be a throwback. No.
Incomplete.
Even if he had caught the ball, it would not have been enough. That was a great play on Aiden Morganelli and Landon Williams in the coverage over here. So that Bayou Academy defense, we like to call them the Big Blue Wrecking Crew. They come through for you at home. So let's give a big round of applause for that defense. You've got to be enjoying that if you're a Bayou Academy Colt fan.
So now we got to take that momentum off that stop where we had some bad breaks, and we got to turn it into points.
We're coming out wide left with William Jeffries, wide right with Landon Williams. One man in the backfield, and you know him, you love him. It's Aiden Morganelli. And there he goes. I've got a new name for Aiden Morganelli. We've been calling him the Italian Stallion, but I think I like him better known as the Thunderbolt from the Middle East. The old Thunderbolt from the Middle East, Reverend O.M. McGee. Bayou Academy Colts. Just keep feeding the ball.
5:45 to go in the second quarter.
Three receivers in the pattern. Mitchell Jones have yet to throw a pass. Let's see if it's here, one here.
No.
No, right up the middle. And there goes the Thunderbolt. Bam! Just
watch,
like lightning. He's got
yellow.
One man to beat.
Watch for old yellow.
And that guy is not going
watch
to
for
catch
old yellow.
Him.
I don't see old yellow.
Gold shoes at all. No yellow on the field. Those gold cleats were gleaming in the skylight of the football stadium lights as Aiden Morganelli takes it to the house. Touchdown, Bayou Academy. Todd, how do you like the legs and the wheels on old Aiden Morganelli?
I like them. I like them a lot.
I think I called the new nickname just in time, that Thunderbolt, and boom, thunderstruck. Well, lightning boat, rather, and that lightning struck, Todd.
So I think we'll probably go to two here to try to get this.
Lee Academy with their heads down, you can see the dissension on the sideline. And when that feeling starts to ease in, that momentum builds for Bayou Academy. 12-0 is your score, awaiting the two-point conversion. Bootleg to Mallett.
Got
and Mallett's got it.
Mallett's in
PAT is good.
Into the end zone. Two-point conversion.
conversion converted. Hi, Jeffries, Joey Mallon, and we love it over here in Lee as the Bayou Academy Colts have taken a commanding lead 14-0.
Yep, 5:18 to go in the second. I'm still not comfortable. I don't know when I can get comfortable in a game. I've yet to find that spot.
Well, the last time you weren't comfortable, Bayou Academy was up 21-0. The team, at the half, it was 28-6. And we thought we were in for a big blowout and a roll. And as you called it, the Mag Heights team came back and scored two back-to-back touchdowns within a few minutes of each other and made a game of it. Now, we did pull that out. So I think that sometime your intuition tells you, hey, I've seen D1 Money run the ball, and he's only a step away from doing the same thing that Aiden Morgan
did. And I would not kick the ball to D1 Money right here. I'd rather see us just kick it out of bounds if we had to.
Well, there's something to say about speed. I would like to point out that Borganelli's shoes are solid gold on the bottom, and as he was running, the lights were gleaming off the shoes. And if you're going to wear a shoe like that, or a red shoe like Billy White shoes Johnson used to wear, if you're going to wear a different color shoe, you better be fast.
Upback takes this ball. Down. Good
what
call
a break.
By the referee.
Wow. What a break for the Bayou Academy Colts. Oh, referee made him a...
The first and 10, Lee Academy Colts.
I'm going to agree with the ref on that one, Todd. His knee did touch the ground.
It did. 20-yard line for Lee Academy, so they got to go the length of the field here.
If you're sitting at home, I just want you to realize that all these kids came out of Cleveland, Mississippi on that Bayou team. You've done a fantastic job as parents and grandparents back home. You got to be proud. Poke your chest out and look at the TV screen as that scores 14-0.
So
in the favor of your Colts.
Desi's going to go out wide right.
He's probably going to come look in a motion. Right. Yeah, look for him right there. There it is.
End around.
And they've got it. Mallett's got to turn him in. He does. He turns him in, and there it goes.
Not going to get him.
Let him go. Look out.
That's number one touchdown, Desi Monix, Lee Academy Colts.
I hate to say I called it, but did I call it? Just like that. The ball game is back within a touchdown. You never can count D1 Money. They don't get those kind of names for nothing. And D1 just cashed in his chip and says, hey, guys, we're not going to let you get too far out ahead. Let me catch this ball game up. Now, Bo Linkus made a super effort coming across the field. He used up a lot of energy. But let me tell you, so did D1 Money.
Yep. Well, what that does is it's one play instead of 12 out of Lee Academy. So D1 can get his rest.
Well, here we go. Let's see. Are they going straight back to D1 or are they going to do the little bootleg out? It's the bootleg. Look out! Decent Lamb slings him back, comes up, and look at this. Intercepted in the end zone.
By Braden Davis.
Davis, number 23, jumps up in front of the would-be receiver and makes a tremendous interception. Good play, Braden Davis. Yes, indeed. I see it right now. Ronnie Aguzzi sitting there. He's saying, great play, Braden. Great play.
So, we got 5 minutes. What I'd like to see us do, Joey, if Aiden can't take one quickly to the house, let's eat up some clock. Because Lee Academy's going to get this ball in the second half.
Well, we've got an 8-point lead. That's a pretty good cushion. And it was a one strike there as D1 came in motion. They moved him from tailback over to where he's comfortable, as you pointed out in the front of the game, that he's normally in a slot position. He ran that from a slot position. And what that did was opened up the other side on the outside, and all he needed was a step. And when he got that step time, he was gone. Nothing you can do about it. Not poor defense, not alignment. Everything, the stars line up sometimes, and the big money guys make the play. Well, let's see what Bayou Academy can do. 5 minutes, plenty of time. I would love to go up 21-6 at half, give us a bigger cushion. Let's see if that happens. Are they going to kick it to Aiden Borganelli? No, it's a spinner. And William Jeffries, Todd,
for some reason, they key on William Jeffries in about six ball games, and they kick that up.
First and 10, ball catch.
He uses good common sense, grabs it, and puts us at the 41-yard line. Who wouldn't want that? Who wouldn't want that field position?
He seems to get a lot of these squirrely kicks that are kind of bouncing.
And a lot of those squirrely kicks wind up being fumbles, as you know, so he's been done a good job of maintaining possession. William Jeffries out wide to the left. Bo Lincus now in a slot position. Todd, I'm looking for Bo Lincus to come right here on the end of round. Let's see if that's going to be the case. No, feed it to Aiden. Feed it to our speedster. First down.
That's number two, Aiden Morgan. Oh, they don't care for Bo. Stop by number one, Desi Monty.
Clock is ticking. They're going to call it second down and a long one.
We just be second and one, Bayou Academy.
4:40 to go in the second quarter. Somebody's got a timeout, maybe an official timeout.
Maybe. It'll be our first official timeout. Todd, I've enjoyed this ball game. By the way, you and I started doing the broadcast about 3 years ago. I've enjoyed the whole three-year run. Had a lot of good times up here, a lot of laughs, watched a lot of good football. Of course, we've been on the winning side of a lot of that. So I just want to say thank you for helping me commentate. It's been a wonderful season, and couldn't ask for a better partner.
I've enjoyed it too, my friend. And, I hope the folks at home get a little something out of what we do. They may not get all of the references we make, but that's what Google's for, right?
That's right. That's right. Well, the Bayou Academy Colts are poised as Aiden Morganelli took the first run for 9 yards. Scores 14-6 in the favor of the Bayou Academy Colts.
Let's see if we put this ball in the air here.
I haven't seen it all night.
Except on that two-point play.
He's looking for the edge. He cuts it up, and there he goes. He's gone.
There's a flag. I think they got it on Ryan Dawson.
Touchdown, Bayou Academy, number two, Aiden Borganelli.
Well, we're going to have to wait on the flag.
And flag on the play.
Let's see what they call. Block.
Block in the back against Bayou Academy.
Man, I'm going to have to go back and look at that one, too.
I did not, I just saw the flag come out. I will say this. It was a fairly early flag. It was not as, when Aiden was at the 10. He had just broken free and the flag was thrown.
Well, they're going to probably have to give Aiden a rest. It was a long run.
I did see Borganelli turn around about the 20 because he sent something.
I saw Mallett raising his hand. It could have been on 33. We'll have to wait.
He was
and
the only
see
guy
the
back there. I just.
View. Well, then if he was the only one back there, it had to be him.
But I just didn't see the actual block.
Well, let's regroup and reboot. 4 minutes and 21 seconds left before halftime. Bayou Academy up 14-6. Here comes Brandon Crocker. And Bo Link is out wide left. Ryan Dawson Mallett and William Jeffries out wide right. Mitchell Jones in the shotgun. He's going to be passing. He's looking for a man open. He throws the ball.
Deep.
It's short. William Jeffries made a gallant effort after the ball. He just got a paw on it. And it falls
play was number 14, Graydon Burke.
If you ask William Jeffries, and I will, what he thought about that, he'd probably tell you he should have caught that ball. I know he had to jump for it, but went through his hands. So.
Well, that was a long ball. Mitchell Jones threw the ball pretty good. Jeffries going off the field to get a breather. For about a 40-yard pass there.
Big third down here.
Third and 13. Big play. Don't want to turn it over to Lee just quite yet. We would like to eke out that first down play.
Mitchell rolls
Mallett
out.
Is open. Mallett's got to get up the field, though. He's got to go.
He's
come
up
on,
the
Mallett.
Field. Let's see.
Whoa!
Joseph.
He's got the wheels going.
Safety.
Can he get him? Oh, knocks him just out of bounds.
That was number 33, Rylan Dawson Mallett.
All that time.
Oh,
my goodness. And the speed at it
three,
paid off for it.
Finally paid off. Oh, Ryan Dawson Mallett. He was going down that sideline, smooth sailing. He gets about a 60-yard run to make up for the
first down.
Evidently
oh,
the block okay. In the back. But Ryan Dawson has put the team in good position now. 4 minutes and 4 seconds left, and he's driven the ball. Where was that, Todd? Down to about the 14-yard line.
Yep.
Good pass.
pass for Mitchell Jones. He put that ball on the money. So big time throw for number 15, Mitchell Jones. Aiden Borganelli in the backfield. Bayou Academy threatening again. They give it to Aiden up the middle. He's got a seam. He breaks loose on one. He breaks loose on two. And he's going to get about 8 yards
on the run. Play.
Ty, that comes from, you mentioned the speed addict. You talk about, I know you put your kid over in the agility training at Delta Sports Fitness. And, you know, that pitter-patter of the feet that Aiden just did, that's all agility. It's balance. You're balancing on one leg to the other leg. It just doesn't come all naturally. It's something you have to work at. All these practices, all these drills, and in the end, you know, we don't know if we're wasting money and getting all these lessons, but in the end, when you see them run like that and do the little the cuts, you start to think, hey, man, it was worth it. They're getting something out of it. It's being productive. Yeah. And Bayou Academy has shown that all year.
I think there's, you know, particularly with Borganelli, there's a certain level of God-given ability there. But
first and 10, Bayou Academy.
In, and a lot of these young men put in a lot of that extra work just to make them that much better, you know?
Absolutely. And you know, as you know, it's a tough, physical, violent sport down there. These guys are not playing checkers, believe me. They're hitting each other in the mouth.
And
if you watch closely, you can see a lot of it. First down and goal. Pitch to Bo Lincas. He's got a lane. Bo Lincas is going to take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Bo Lincas, number one, and that's the effort we needed.
Bo Lincas
back off the injury from last week, and that's what you need Bo Lincas for. He comes in and gives you a balance. They threw the pass. They went to Aiden, and all of a sudden, out of the backfield, bam, magic happens. Bo Lincas into the end zone. Bring that lead up to 20-6, Todd, in the all-important extra point. Let's see if Kellen Allen can get one through here. Landon Williams, your holder. Landon Vargas, number 46 in the game, as well as Parker George. Oh, yes, he made this one a no-doubter. He put that one up in between the post, right down the heart, and that is a point conversion. Good kick for Kellen Allen. 21-6, your score.
So good drive. You know, I think Lee has probably kind of come to the realization that they're going to have to score every time.
Oh, yes.
And that's going to have to be predominantly through Desi Monix. And so look for them to get him the ball to try to get a score to cut it to 7 or 8 before halftime.
I love the song they're playing. We're not going to take it anymore. And what I'm referring to is those penalty flags. We're not going to take it anymore. We've had some problems with penalties all year long. A lot of them are mistakes on the field, and then some of them are subjective. But overall, Bayou Academy Colts 6-2 on the season. Ty Jeffries, Joey Mallett from the press box, Clarksdale, Mississippi. Your Bayou Academy Colts winning this one, 21-6. Pending the kickoff, they're going to try to keep it away from D1 money. I tell you that. And yes, they do. Picked up by the quarterback. There's a play. Oh, fumble. No. He's dragged down hard.
Good 20. Tackle there by
number three,
kicker, Kellen Allen.
How about the old kicker, number 20, Kellen Allen? He gets his name
20.
Mentioned a lot of times
Kellen
when he kicks
Allen.
These extra points. And he's caught a few passes this year. And now he comes down, and it's not often, Todd, that you see the kicker make a tackle.
Right. Great tackle by Kellen.
Good job.
So let's see.
You
if
can
we,
smile, Clint. We know you're watching. You can smile. You can smile. Let it out.
Let's see if we put like a spy or somebody on Monix here. He's going to be
yes.
That typical running back spot now.
I think we need to get either Bo or Aiden to shadow D1. But let's see what the coaches have called up. Here we go. Here comes a little play. It's pitched back over. It's a screen pass. Well set up. And there, oh, yeah, game. You better
get him to the ground.
Let him drive him. Look at that.
Pass was completed.
You want to know what leg drive is. You don't want to know what power is. You want to know what the measuring bar is. You take a look at old D1. He had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Colts on him. And, buddy, he still drove for about 7 yards.
Yeah, and you want the these Colt defenders to understand, get him down low, get him at the legs, and if you do, he can't drive those legs on.
Absolutely.
But otherwise, it's still a pretty good defensive play on what could have been a dangerous play.
Well, that was a good screen play, good call.
Another
right up the middle. He's still up. Get him low. And a gang of Colts, we'll call it a
number
herd.
One, Desi Monty's on the carry for
me. I think that's the difference in the game. If you, if I quit saying it's a gang coming over to get him and it's a herd of Colts, he goes down quicker. Them Bio Academy Colts. That's the big blue wrecking crew. Griffin Peoples, Bryce Clark, Anderson Short, and Corey Barfield across that front line. And don't forget, old number 74, Hill Lasker.
I'm glad we got a timeout.
Look, we've got Eason Lamb is up on the front line. Did you see that?
Yeah.
Eason Lamb was in on the front line. He was going to try to dart through that offensive line and make a play in the backfield. That's who they put on D1 money. I guarantee you they had him going in there trying to hit D1 at the feet. So, look, all your Colts have been out tonight. Mitchell Jones with some great passes. Ryan Dawson Mallett with a couple of runs and a couple of catches. You've got Aiden Borganelli, the star of the show. He's running down the field making plays. Anderson Short has made some big plays up front along with Griffin Peoples. And don't forget about the play that Corey Barfield made on D1 money early in the game where he hit him in the sternum.
You know, I think right now with 2.5 minutes to go, this is a big spot in this game. Either Lee's going to continue to have life and score and be in this ball game, or Bayou's going to find a way to stop them and hopefully take control of the game.
Look, as in all sports like this, boxing, rugby, football, any of those tough sports, this is the District 4 champions. Never take them lightly. They're down 21-6, but they're not out of it. The way you get their attention is strictly you go out and you hit them in the mouth. You let them know who's boss. And Bio Academy has done a good job of that tonight. It's a tough Lee team, and Bio Academy's just a little bit tougher. Right up the
hand
middle.
Off to Monix.
It's always dangerous when he's got the ball. He drags the pile. He's going to get about 6 yards.
Monix on the
carry. Second down and two. Biggest competitor they have against them right now, that's Lee Coach we're speaking of. We're in the 2-minute warning, the red zone, 2 minutes to go before halftime. And that clock is ticking against them. And Todd, they don't seem to care. They just trot out a play.
I think part of that is that they are going to get the ball to start the second half, and they want to keep it out of our offense hands. So they want to hold this ball.
They would like to do both. They could score and get the ball at half. They would be in the driver's seat.
Hand up off the middle.
Oh, he's got a hole. He's got a seam. Uh-oh, they caught Bio sleeping. And a rundown from behind, Eason Lamb.
That's number 20.
Yes, another tackle.
For Lee Academy.
They were all keying in on D1 money. And number 20.
First and 10, Lee Academy coach.
Took that ball right up the middle. Last time when they did that, Big Anderson Short cut him down to size. But this time he gets free outside. And Todd, that goes for a big play.
Hey,
and the clock stops as well. For the first down markers to move.
Good play call by Lee Academy there.
Absolutely. Big fullback, number 20 is in the backfield. This is going to D1. Right to D1. He makes a cut. He's got a seam. Oh, he's still on his feet. He's got, oh, good. Oh, I can keep saying oh. He's like a yo-yo. He was in. He was out. He was turned. He went sideways. He gets 8 yards. Now it's 10. First down, Lee Academy. Great run by D1 Money. That's why they call him D1 Money. Because when he gets the ball, buddy, it's money. Money in the bank. Bio Academy faithful at home, watching this on your live screen. What a football game we have tonight. Bio Academy trying to finish out the year as well as the Lee Academy Colts. And it's been one slug fest. Right up the money. Oh, good play right there. There it was. I called it earlier. It was none other than Anderson.
Number 20, Peyton Burton on the carry for the Colts.
He cut him down to size there. Only a 1 yard gain. Anderson Short.
By number 63,
not
Anderson
this
Short.
Time. Number 20, meet Anderson Short. Number 63. That was a good play for that big blue wrecking crew of the Bayou Academy Colts. I formation as they've been in almost all night.
Flag on the play.
I believe it may have been the receiver lined up in the neutral zone. They'll talk it over. Yep. Coach is calling him over.
Offsides. On the offense.
There it is. Big blue wrecking crew likes that.
You don't see that call much because usually these receivers are checking with the umpires to make sure they're.
Well, Lee Academy has all three timeouts. Well, they may have two timeouts. They got 41 seconds left before the half. If they could somehow punch it in the end zone, they can make it a ball game.
I mean, I hate to be pessimistic, but I don't think time's a real big issue right now for Lee. They got to draw up a
play. He's looking for the receiver. He throws the bomb. Who is
it? An interception.
Who is it?
By Borganelli.
Borganelli. Oh, my goodness. He was
big
one
play.
Step away from making them pay.
So now.
That was intercepted by number two, Aiden Borganelli.
I couldn't tell who got the pressure on the quarterback back here. I didn't see a number. But the quarterback, he caused him to throw a wobbly pass. It went high and off target. And Aiden was there to make the pickoff.
I almost think they
wanted to come
into that quarterback because there were about six guys on him. So the whole defense was back there. They just couldn't get that matchup right on the pass.
Well, if you're Bayou Academy here, we've seen them do crazier things, but I don't know here.
I think you hand it to Aiden Borganelli and say, try to score.
Todd Jeffrey says, try to score.
Davis in there right now, so maybe Borganelli's just getting a little bit of a
give it to number 15 and let him take a knee.
Fake. Back to
Bo Lincus. To the 50-yard line.
Bo has got to understand right there. He's got to get out of bounds.
Stop by number three, Brayden Antici.
They were still running the clock. They didn't stop. It should have been stopped when
I think we had to call a timeout, but it would have if Bo had just got, you know, and it's easy for me to say. We're talking about ninth graders here, but, you know, Bo just takes a couple. So he wanted to break the tackle, but if he'd gotten out of bounds, clock would have stopped. But we had plenty of timeout, so Iron Maiden here.
Play the music. They've got the music over here at Lee Academy.
Excuse me, Black Sabbath playing, my bad.
If you want to know how to get the music selection, here it comes. Take a page out of the old Lee Colt music book. I know. It brings you back to yesteryear. Stands are full, getting ready for the Bayou Academy cheerleaders to do their thing at halftime. They're all excited about the halftime dancing, and they've done a good job all year. Well-trained girls, great athletes, great acrobats. And your football team is a great one, too. Mitchell Jones, number 15's back. Let's see if he throws the deep ball. He threw one earlier to William Jeffries. William's not in there, but he's looking deep. Mallet's wide open, but he's looking across the middle. No, that one's going to the turf. 7 seconds
left. Pass is incomplete.
Mallet was wide open, but it was only for a short gain. And down the sideline over there, I think he looked first. His first target was Landon Williams. He was covered. He looked back to Bo Lincus across the D center section about 25 yards down, but the ball fell harmless to the ground. So Bayou Academy, Todd, you'd have to say, very, very aggressive in their play call. They're up 21-6. They've thrown three bombs.
Yeah. I think we'll probably see Borganelli here, but I could be wrong.
I would love to see the old hook and ladder here. Just run a short little out, throw the little hook, and let Borganelli bounce off of that hook. You saw it. You saw it in the old Boise State game when they played Oklahoma.
Oh! That could have been a disaster.
Woo! You talking about they almost fumbled that ball.
And Bayou Academy calls a timeout with 0.8 seconds left in the half.
So Linkus and Borganelli run into each other. If you had had a fumble there, Lord have mercy, it would have been.
Well, not only the fumble would have been very bad, of course, but an injury right here before the second half could get started. The Lee Academy coach are not out of it, guys. You've been watching the game. You saw the speed they have over there. So Bayou Academy is in a dogfight, no less than they've been all year long. We're in a tough division, a tough district. We are fifth district. By the way, the Starkville Volunteers went undefeated, and we only lost one game. Your Bayou Academy faithful lost one game, and that game was to Starkville. It was a pretty close game. We had an early lead at 7, and at halftime, I think that they may have been up 12-7, and then from there, it just kind of went downhill. But Bayou Academy, believe me, they've been battling not just this year, not last year, but the year before. So they've got a great crew of athletes coming up. Bayou Academy football is live and well in Cleveland, Mississippi.
Jones is going to be under center.
Pitch. There goes the clock. He's got to beat the big man.
Come on, Aiden. Get there.
Come on.
Get there, buddy.
One man to beat. William Jeffries there. He's going in the end zone. Touchdown.
That's number 2, Aiden Borganelli on
Look
the touchdown.
Look for the flag.
Oh,
flags. No flags. Ty,
deja vu to Senatobia, Joey.
Lightning strikes twice. We were in Mag Heights just not too long ago, and we had a full second left on the clock, and Aiden Borganelli took it for 70 yards. Tonight, fast forward, it looked like a replay. We had 0.8 seconds left on the clock. We decided to do a pitch out. He starts out on the right side of the field and cuts all the way across. Todd, that was over a 100-yard run.
We saw Jeffries out there, and we're kind of just like, look, don't try to block somebody, just get in the way. And that's all he did, and that's all. And Aiden may have scored anyway, but it was.
No, Jeffries did a good job. It's kind of like in flag football, you know, back when we played flag, you had to get in front of them, because if you hit them, it would be a penalty. And Jeffries went back to his old flag base, and he was just enough in front of him where he caused the guy to take a step to the right, and Aiden just slid in, just like it was drawn up. And Todd, if you look at the scoreboard, not only was it the same play, it's the same score.
Yeah, 28-6. So we know what can happen. And so we'll take a few-minute break and be back with you here on Bayou Academy JV football.
Todd Jeffries. Todd Jeffries, Joey Mallett, live at Clarksdale Lee, where your Bayou Academy Colts are up 28-6.
You know, it's been a little bit of a closer game than that. Lee Academy's driven the ball down a few times, has turned the ball over on downs. So they're going to be looking to score here and get back in this ball game.
Well, Todd, and as you know, let's mention that number 55, Red Wine, will be back in the game.
Ooh, great kick.
Oh, great kick right there. Let's see if they can pin him in.
Cover it, though.
Oh, my goodness.
And number three, Braden Antici on the return for the coach.
Griffin Peoples.
Griffin Peoples goes for the knockout.
Stopped by number 25.
He put that big shoulder in, and whew, that running back didn't want no part of that, Todd.
Yeah. Not the best coverage there.
Right in front of Todd Jeffries and I, right on the sideline, big Griffin Peoples. If you haven't seen him play all year, he's very quick-footed for a big man. Number 72, keep an eye on him on that front line, right in the trenches.
I'd look for Monix to get the ball as many times as he can handle it.
Well, at this point, you're down three scores. Somebody's going to have to make a play. And there he is. Oh, hit him in the leg. Get that leg. Woo-hoo. Shoulder tackle. One man to beat. He's out of bounds. They're not going to call him out of bounds.
That's number one, Dizzy Monix on the carry for Lee Academy.
You know, you say.
Stop by number 14, Landon Williams.
Say, get a leg. I saw like the two or,
and
first,
number
two or three missed tackles
Barfield.
On Monix were up the legs. They just weren't.
Well, I'm going to tell you what. If you're sitting at home watching this one on the big screen, you got a first-class ticket to the moon. You're not going to see too many running backs that you're looking at tonight. One Aiden Borganelli, and on the other side, D1 Money. You saw the moves. He is unbelievable. Feed him again. This time, Easton Lamb holds on. He's going all the way back across field, and he falls down.
As
you see,
Easton
Lamb had him dead to rights. Todd, somehow the power in those hips and those leg drive are just breaking tackles,
yeah,
making people look bad, but they really have good angles and good fundamental tackling. Sometimes you come across some athletes like the two on the field tonight.
And you
that
can, you
have
can,
that extra gear.
You can look at Monix right now. I mean, he's tired. So we've got to be able to take advantage of a play here and there where he doesn't get the ball and make sure they don't beat us.
Hey, he's going to have to bow up if they plan to win this game. That defense, big blue wrecking crew, here they come. He fakes it. He's looking for the run. He's – oh, big, who is it? It's Easton Lamb on the first.
Number three, Brady Antici on the carry.
Bryce
Stop
Clark.
Number 16,
Griffin Peoples. Bayou Academy, the big blue wrecking crew come through. Third down and 25. Todd, how about the aggressive play from that Bayou defense?
So, yeah, that was kind of the – Monix was going to take that play off. So that was our chance there to try to get a positive defensive play.
Well, and D1 is over with his hands on me. Rightfully so, as you've seen him play offense and defense. It is a big load that he's carrying tonight.
We got to watch him here. He's out wide.
Earlier they had him on the opposite side. They're giving him a play off.
They're going to try to throw him the ball.
Oh.
There's another pick, or almost pick by
Mallett.
Incomplete.
Mallett went to lay the lumber back here deep on the quarterback, and he pulled up, or they would have called it roughing the passer. So good play by Mallett there. And then on the other end, who was going for the interceptions over here?
I think it was Lamb that was in on it.
Lamb was in on an interception over here. So both sides of the defense, the defensive back and the upbacks, were playing great football there. They're going to have to punt, Todd. I don't think they can go for it on 4th and 20, or 4th and 25 for that matter.
Monix is back there with.
Yeah, not a good sight to see.
I don't know what Monix. This could definitely be just a run. He's going to come.
I think that they're deceiving, so we don't have anyone back. Uh-oh. Oh, pretty good punt.
Just let it go.
Pretty good punt.
It's going to get inside the 10.
Great punt by the Lee Colts to stay in this one. Pins our Colts, the Bayou Colts, inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. Just an excellent play. They decoyed D1 Money back by the punter to say, hey, wait a minute, they may do some kind of fake here. And we brought our punt returner up, and they kicked it right down the middle to the 9-yard line.
That's what a guy like that can do for you. You just
absolutely.
Kinda...
just a good football strategy. That's what football is all about. It's kind of like chess. You make a move here, and the other coach makes a move there. Bayou Academy's coming out with their first possession. Can Ill afford a fumble or an interception down low at the 9-yard line?
Braden Davis in it running back.
Let's see what happens. Mitchell Jones, shotgun formation.
Hand off to Davis.
Ooh, he gets hammered. His leg was twisted under him. He may have hurt himself.
I think he's okay.
He's going to get back to the line of scrimmage. No gain.
There's number 23, Braden Davis on the carry for Bayou. Stopped by number 20, Peyton Burton.
Bayou Academy Colts of Cleveland leading this one 28-6. Start of your third quarter. A lot of yardage put up in that first half of ball.
Davis,
and here we come.
In at running back.
Let's see if
Linkus in motion. He
this
gets
is Linkus. He's looking for a seam.
Stretch it out to the outside. He's
They've
not
got his
get
shirt
anywhere.
Tail. He's not going anywhere. He may get a yard.
Number one, Bo Linkus on the carry for Bayou.
I think he gets
by number 22,
line.
Brown
no
Hags. And
down.
Number 54, Wynn Spink.
So Bayou stifled on their first possession.
The third and 11 for Bayou.
Bayou Academy come out with a straight dive play. Then they came in with the speed play. Got negative yardage. Third down and long. Can't get too cute here, Todd. Probably just going to keep the ball on the ground. Let's see what they call. Well, he's in the end zone.
Safety.
That's looking a safety for Lee Academy.
They were looking for Brandon Crocker over here on this side. Mitchell Jones, the play was late to develop. Lee got a big push, and he is tackled into the end zone. So Lee Academy Colts are happy with that. They draw first blood. 2 points, 28-8. How about that? Todd Jeffries, Joey Mallett from your live stream. Hope you're enjoying the show. You should be if you're a Bayou Academy Colt fan. 28-6. You're listening to Bayou Academy Colt football.
So now the lead's 20. I guess the one positive is we can hopefully put Lee in a little worse field position than if we had punted. We got to be careful here on where this ball goes on this. I don't know if we're going to free kick it or just kick it off. I think Kellen's probably more comfortable just kicking it off. So
evidently,
move.
We had a big penalty.
So
a roughing penalty. We're kicking it from the 20.
Yeah, so Monix has moved over to where Kellen has been kicking it. I hope that Kellen and the coaching staff sees that and responds accordingly.
That was good coordination of music. They were playing the safety dance.
Yep, and Allen kicks it.
Oh, he's going
to
return.
Right, but they're.
Oh, my goodness. They'll start at the Bayou Academy 40-yard line, and this game is not
Someone
sealed.
Has lost the Lexus key fob. It is in the concession stand.
So, just noting some personnel issues. Crocker's out there. Braden Davis is playing safety. Aiden Borganelli has not been in this quarter, so I think I know kind of what the thought process is. So we may not see Aiden this quarter. We'll see if we see him next quarter.
Looks like a blitz formation. Oh, I like that. I like that. Number 70, Corey Barfield in on the play, along with Ryan Dawson Mallett, number 33.
Is number 22, Brown Harris on the camp.
Corey Barfield.
Stopped by number
70,
Corey Barfield.
Yes, indeed.
The second and 11 for the coach.
So that is Dennis Barfield's young man.
You got our three linebackers, Mallett, Jeffries, and Linkus. You got Crocker and Landon Williams at corner. Braden Davis in at safety. Our normal D line. And we got to watch out for them trying to get the ball into Monix's hand.
There's the pitch, number 22. He's got a little speed.
He makes a great cut. Oh, one man to beat, another cut, two cuts. Where's this guy come from? He lowers his shoulder.
That was number 22, Brown.
And he's down to the 15-yard line. A tale of two halves.
Old yellers out there, though, Joey.
Look number 23, Braden Davis.
Look at Anderson Short. Anderson Short did the old zebra march off. Now, he marched back 5 yards and bring it back,
perhaps
boys.
That's who was
bring
held.
It back.
Flag on the play. It's against the coach.
Anderson's like, look.
That would be the Lee Colts.
The penalty was on me. I'm not going down the field.
That's it. He stayed there. I like that march. He could have been in the marching band. He threw that foot out there, and he marched it back 5 yards.
So, you know, both teams have had some long plays called back, and, you know, I don't.
Kind of counseled each other out on the flags.
The referees have. Apart from maybe an early call or two, appear to be calling it, you know, pretty straight here. Nothing to really complain about. We got to tackle better.
Well, here comes that Bayou big blue wrecking crew. Let's see what they can do with D1 money. Come on, flag on the play. Big D1 money is going to have to come back on this one too. Go ahead, D. Go the end zone, D. Landon Williams.
At number one, Debbie Monick, but there's a flag on the field.
A flag on the field.
Holding Lee Academy.
Oh, the Lee Academy fans are not happy with the Zebras' call on those plays. We'll have to go back on the replay and take a look at it. Unfortunately, in ninth grade football, there is no replay.
I will say again, that flag was early. You know, you called it.
Holding. Against the Colts. Woo! These fans are not happy.
And
tomatoes, lettuce heads, all hitting the field.
If you're Monix and you just ran down the field, you've got to be frustrated.
Frustrated.
Because probably, Joey, that hole probably didn't play a part in that play success. Maybe it did, but I doubt it did.
Well, here we go. That backs them up. It's second and 40. Right up, it's a draw play. There it is. And knocked down.
Number 20, Peyton Burton on the carry for the coach.
Looked like Landon Williams was in on the tackle.
Tackle by number 14, Landon Williams.
Woo! Big Landon Williams. He comes across with a big play. That is a cousin to Anderson Short. Landon Williams has let his presence been felt tonight on Lee Academy's field. Backs out. It's another play. Following his blockers well. I like the way this cat runs. Number 22. He's got a little quick feet. And he gets an angle. And Todd, if you don't get low on him, buddy, he gets down under you and gives you a jolt.
Fourth and 17. Monix coming back in the game. He's going to get the rock here, I would imagine.
Well, here we go. Man, we are having fun in Lee tonight. 2 minutes and 20 seconds left in the third quarter. Your Bayou Academy Colts up 28-8 after just giving up a safety.
Monix gets.
Here comes their key man, Wonder Man.
Number one, Bo Lincas.
That's what we're talking about with Lincas, that lateral agility. He's got the strength. Made probably the only player on our team that could have made that play, and it was in a really big spot on fourth down.
Absolutely. You know him. You love him, and you're glad to have him back. Old Bo Lincas, number one, comes up and puts the big stop on the Lee offense. It's going to be a turnover on downs. And here comes the offense.
2 minutes, 8 seconds to go.
The whistle, the ball has been blown into play. Oh, we got a lot of shuffling going on. This is probably going to be a penalty on Lee if they snap the ball. They do snap it.
Hand off to Mallett. He's trying to get around. Mallett's got to get north and south, and he's trying to.
They tore his whole jersey off. It's laying over here on the side. Look at his hand.
Mallett on the carry.
They couldn't pull him down. He leans forward, and he's going to get about 3 yards on the play, but he doesn't have a jersey. Half a jersey's gone off his back.
you know, Mallett probably didn't have that hole that was designed up the middle, so he tried to get it outside.
Well, number 52, Harris Stone Street.
Made something where there wasn't much there for him.
Yeah, that ball was supposed to go in the four hole. It wound up bouncing out to the six or the eight hole.
Not sure
that's
why.
Not where you want to run him. He wants to be on the inside.
Right now. I guess they went out of bounds.
Evidently. Here we go. Second down. Fake to Mallett. Pitch to Bo Lincoln. He's gone. Bo's got one step. One step.
Oh, good tackle by number three.
Number one, Bo Lincoln, for the reception for Bayou. Stopped by number three, Braden Antisi.
Well, when I was a little kid,
he's first and 10, Bayou
I used Academy. To watch a show called Welcome Back, Cotter. Everybody remembers that with Vinny Barbarino and Horshack. And tonight, I would like to get a big welcome back to old Bo Lincoln. He's been a tool for us tonight as Aiden Borganelli is setting the third quarter out. Of course, that will free him up a little bit to play some high school ball tomorrow night.
And I think what they'll
do. That's a good idea.
What they'll do is see where we are in the fourth and respond accordingly.
28-8 on a big play to Bo Lincoln as he swung that ball out. I like the play. And Bo liked the play.
Yeah.
And Mitchell Jones
now you did
gets
call
another 40
it, you
yards.
You did call Bo being, you said he was gone and he did get tripped up.
Yeah.
Now,
slip of the tongue.
Bo is fast, but he's not.
Penalty flag down.
Fast.
Delay a game.
Borganelli.
Delay a game, Bo.
You're right. I did think he was gone. I saw that step, and number three made a good play. You called out.
That's Antisi, yeah.
That's Antisi. Antisi made a great play over there. First down and 15.
Hand off to Mallett.
Mallett makes a good move. He's going to power up. He powers the ball over. He's going to get about
5 yards. That was number 33, Ryan Dawson Mallett on the carry for Bayou.
He's going to get 5 yards.
Number 54, Wynn Spinks.
Second down and 12.
Clock ticks to around a minute to go in the third.
Lee seems to be on their heels. They're not sure what to think about this. They are the District 4 champions, and they're down 28-8. Not a comfortable position for them. Mitchell Jones in the shotgun formation. There's the pitch to Easton Lamb. Lamb's.
There's the flag. They're going to call it on Peepers. And that was the old
number 16,
double flag.
Lamb on the carry. Stopped by number 54.
Well, let's give the Zebras some credit now. We've been down on them a little bit. Now, that
flag
was
on the play.
A good call. Peoples did have a hold to him.
Holding Bayou Academy.
And even Peoples knew. He put his hands over his ears and
Peoples is not,
backed it up.
Not really complaining. I think he knows what happened.
Good run for Easton Lamb, nonetheless. 41 seconds left in your third quarter. Bayou Academy Colts leading 28-8. Glad to have you with us at home. Hope you're enjoying the ball game. It is a beautiful October night in 2022. Trips to the right. Uh-oh. Bo, somebody's out of position.
Got Mallett.
Yeah, we've got second down and 30. Fakes to Mallett, hits to Bo Lincoln. I believe he got the first down. He might be, he could be, he should be.
Touchdown.
Number one.
Touchdown! Bayou Coach Todd, that was a smooth play. They ran the same play to the left earlier. Why not come back to the right with it? The coaches made a good read there, faked it to Mallett up the middle, pulled out Mitchell Jones through a bullet.
Yeah.
Great pass, see, Lincoln's, great catch.
Lincoln may have re-aggravated that knee because he is running a little gingerly. At this point. So Kellen Allen.
He's got a cramp.
Okay.
They're trying to get the cramp out of his leg.
You always
but you noticed
love
it.
To
I,
see,
you, saw
you always
that from
love, love to see the stretch on a cramp as opposed to some sort of extending the leg, wondering if it's a major injury.
Old Eagle Eye Jeffries.
PAT is good.
Looks across the field and notices the cramp in Lincoln's leg. Looks like he's going to be fine. Kellen Allen up. Ever since Kellen Allen
got a questionable call on the extra point. He has put the rest of them way over the goal post. Good extra point by Kellen Allen.
So 12 seconds to go in the third.
I'm proud of these Bayou Academy Colts. They could have folded up for the season, said, hey, man, that's it for us. But like you said, they look back in their memory banks, and Lee came up when we caught us sleeping off guard a couple of years ago and really put the wood to us. And let me tell you, revenge is sweet. 35-8.
Got a whole quarter left, Joseph. Got a whole quarter left.
Eason Lamb, Leighton Glorioso, Parker George, Bryce Clark, Ryan Dawson Mallett, William Jeffries Bolegas, Landon Williams, and your kicker, Kellen Allen. Here we go. End of the third quarter on this kick.
Great kick.
Oh my goodness.
Be trouble if it checks up. It's up.
He stopped it at the 1 yard line. Come on. Somebody get him. He steps out of bounds. Referee didn't call it for some reason, but here we go. He's out.
Braden Antici.
Pretty good return for their return man.
Stopped by number 62.
Kellen Allen stopped it on the 1 yard line.
Stops on the one. You got to get the guys down there.
First and 10, Lee Academy coach.
Good job by Lee blocking some of our guys up.
Well, here comes that big blue wrecking crew, Todd. They've done an excellent job all night bottling up, holding the Colts to an 8 points, two of them coming off a safety. So one touchdown is the offensive power of Lee Colts so far. And Bayou Academy, we love it that way.
6 seconds. I'd imagine Monix gets the ball here. And he does.
Here he comes. He's looking for the outside edge. He cuts it back in. He does a little dance. He twirls, and down he goes. Who is that?
That is 16. Danny Monix on the carry.
Eason Lamb, that's been a common name we've called. He was all over D1 that time. Eason Lamb had hold of that cleat, and he wasn't letting go. That will be the end of your third quarter. Todd Jeffries, Joey Mallett, at the end of three, it's your Bayou Academy Colts 35 and the Lee Colts 8. So it appears that the Bayou Academy Colts will have a tremendous season. Man, it was worth the watch. We went to every game, and every game was exciting.
Joey, I am just not comfortable with you calling this game with a full 8 minutes to go.
Full 8 minutes.
But I appreciate your confidence.
Well, as we've mentioned many times, old Dandy Don, he called in the dogs and put out the fire. The party's over. But you're right. They do have an explosive offense. They are the district champions, and they do have an opportunity. Slim at best. How about those Bayou Academy Colts? Man, you should stand up at your home and write these names down. These guys have performed for you all year long. What entertainment? What better entertainment could you have sitting in Cleveland, Mississippi on a Thursday night watching Bayou Academy football from your Bayou Academy Football Network?
Monix in there, a receiver.
All sports been played to the fullest at Bayou Academy. Of course, we have soccer and basketball coming up. I know one William Jeffries will be on that basketball team. We've done well in track. We've competed at all levels. And the girls' soccer, don't forget, Todd, that was a whale of a game.
Sure was.
They only lost by 1 point.
Second down.
How about that girls' softball team? Man, a lot of athletes right there in Cleveland, Mississippi. Sit back and enjoy. This is going to be a memorable night. They're going to look back this many years from now and say, remember when we
Monix
put it on?
On an end around.
Somebody stayed at home. Who is it? Hold on to him, Griffin. Get him, Griffin. Look at that.
Woo!
That's what I'm
down,
talking about.
And number one, Danny Monix on the
wow.
Kick.
That Bayou Academy defense has had enough of D1. Todd, they couldn't get him down.
Academy Charlie Coates.
But Griffin Peoples was not letting go. I saw his daddy almost fall out of the bleachers with a belly laugh. Hold on to him, Peoples. Hold on to him. By the way, old Jeff Peoples, a graduate of 1982, and his wife, Beth. We know. That's your grandson. 72, Griffin Peoples. Lee Academy Colts are backed up. It'll be a
five-yard
loss on the play, thanks to Griffin Peoples. And there it is. He fakes it. He looks. He throws it to D1. D1 money. Oh, my goodness. Landon would love to have that one back. That was money in the bank. He would have walked into the end zone on a pick six, but you have to catch the football first.
It was a good job by Landon playing the ball and kind of boxing out Monix there.
Fourth down and 15, Todd. Surely you would go ahead and punt it.
I don't think so. I think you're going. Well, yeah, they are.
Well, they're putting the old D money back there.
Back there again, so easy, Landon.
Right there, Landon.
Deep. If they ran a fake that involved Monix, I wouldn't be surprised.
No, it's going to be a straight kick. Here comes Mallett. Pick it up. Run it in, Landon. Run it in, Landon. Good run. Long stride for Landon Williams. He may go. Touchdown! Bayou Academy, the first punt return of the year. Number 14, Landon Williams picks up the bouncing ball as Ryan Dawson Mallett comes over, almost blocks it, and the ball bounces into the hands of one Landon Williams. And Todd, he had a pick six opportunity earlier, and what does he do? Bam! Takes it to the house for the Colts.
Redemption for Landon Williams. On the very next play.
Unbelievable.
He said, I could have scored then, but I'm going to score now.
Well, there you have it. Kellen Allen lining up for the 42nd point, and it is good.
PAT is good.
Well, thanks to the hard charging, fire breathing, dirt slinging plowboy, Landon Williams.
I think what else you're now going to see probably is you're not going to see Mitchell Jones in this game. That touchdown, probably helped that cause.
Well, you can see the bewildered look on the Lee Colts' faces. They're saying, no, where in the world did these guys come from? They come in here like a buzzsaw and have chopped us down. We are the district champions, and we find ourselves behind 42-8. So I can't say enough about those Bayou Academy Colts, Todd.
Yeah, they played really hard tonight, and on these last two scores, Morgan Elliott's gotten some good rest, but he's carried us all year, and some guys have stepped up with him off the field, and we've gotten some points.
Defense
has stepped up.
Here comes the kickoff. Kicks it away from D Money.
And TC.
He's not going far.
Out of bounds.
They're calling the flag. He had him around the leg. William Jeffries had him around the leg, but he was
along the
flag on the plate.
Let's see what the referee calls this. This is not good.
That was a.
It's got to be against Lee because.
No, I think it's against us. They're going to call Jeffrey's tackle out of bounds, which he was right along the sideline. And look, I mean, Lee's been breaking a lot of our tackles all night. We got to get these guys down when we can.
Personal foul, Bayou Academy.
All right, well, that's going to move the ball 15 yards further down the field. Lee Academy Colts will start around the 50-yard line. 6 minutes and 31 seconds left in this one. Bayou Academy Colts up 42-8. They've got 41 on the scoreboard. Maybe they called the extra point no good again.
54. coming into the game, Landon Seha.
Seha, number 54. 24, Trey Pruitt out on the defense at cornerback. Pitch to 22. Penalty flag is down.
I tell you, these guys, these
number 22, refs, Brown Harris on the kick.
They may have gone
flag
to like
on the play.
A ref refresher school this week, and so they're really up on all the calls and what to be looking for.
Holding against Lee Academy.
Yella is flying against both teams.
Holding on
and
Lee.
I certainly don't want to make light of the officials. We appreciate their time. But, you know, you and I both know at this level, JV football, you could probably call a penalty on every play if you wanted to.
That's right.
At this stage in the game,
it's been even, Steven, like you said. It's about 8-9 penalties on one side and 8-9 penalties on the other side. So it's going to square off and make it even.
You got to do an inside kind of.
Boom! That is number 82, Stafford Light. Big Stafford Light, a 6'1 specimen out of Cleveland, Mississippi, comes in and drives the would-be runner to the turf after
number
a short game.
Number 46, Burton on the carry, stopped by.
Stopped by Stafford Light is what he wants to say. Here we go. Big front of the Big Blue Wrecking Crew, and they have been doing some wrecking tonight.
Monix out to the right.
Here comes Stafford Light from the end. He takes care of his man. It's a roll out to the right. He's got a lane. He's got a lane. He's going to make a boast of it, too. One man to beat.
And number 3, Ray Nantese on the kick.
Man, Ty, that's way too many yards. He must have got 30 yards on that play. He found a little lane. I understand that.
Run out of bounds by number 23, Braden Davis.
All right, so now here comes in number 57, William Garrett, who in the other game picked up a scoot 6 earlier in the game. Alongside him is number 88, Leighton Glorioso. Number 88. Let's watch Leighton on the end over there. See if he can break in to make a play.
Somebody better
watch
get
out
on
for number one. No Monix. One's got D1 covered. Here's the pitch to number 22. They're trying to get outside. And oh, what a skip and a hop. And big Stafford.
22, Brown Harris on the carry for Lee Academy.
Smash goes Stafford.
Stopped by number 82 from Bayou Academy.
Got a penalty. It looks like a face mask on the tackle.
Say hi in there.
They're going to have to get these flags and wash
Kellen
them.
Allen has also come in.
These flags have got green grass all over them. They have been used with some authority.
Calling Bo Linkus out. Putting Vargas in. Number 46, Landon Vargas.
You know, the clock's running.
Right up the middle, and I'm going to tell you what, Bayou Academy sniffed that one out, trying to see the number down there. Stafford Light is in on the play.
And number
57, William Garrett in on the play.
Number 82.
William Garrett.
And you know, at this point in the game, we're getting a lot of guys in there.
The second and 12 of Lee Academy.
Lee probably is in a spot where they're going to give the ball to some different folks. I mean, there's no sense in handing the ball to Monix every play at this point. Although I bet you they try to get it to him here.
I can tell you, Monix is probably wore down.
They're looking for him. There's Antisi.
One miss right there. Leighton Glorioso got a hand on him. Just missed him. He's coming up back. He may. Hey! Somebody laid the
left. Number 3, Braden Antisi on the kick.
It looked like Anderson Short. I can only say it was Anderson Short from here. And
that
it was a
62,
fumble.
62, Bryce Clark in on the stop.
And they're going to need a stretcher because
a fumble on the play.
He got leveled. He came off of his feet, Todd, and was levitated, hit down. Pow! On his
I
back.
I think it was Short. He had
recovered by Bayou Academy.
He had a running
Well, that was
right
a great play.
And because Zantisi was doing a good job kind of cutting up and avoiding tackles, but eventually you're going to get hit. You know?
That's why we call them the Big Blue Wrecking Crew, because when you go into the wrecking part right there, like a wrecking ball into a building, he knocked that ball loose. And Zantisi comes up holding his arm and his shoulder, and he's trying to hope he's okay. But it was a whale of a lick.
So is it timeout, or do we have the ball, Joey?
We have the ball.
All right, so I don't know.
We recovered the fumble.
Is Rashard going to come in at quarterback, I would imagine?
It seems that they got the whole squad. And here comes Lee Academy Colt. I love their music program. They're getting beat 42-8, and they come in with their music. You know what it is? That's all right, mama. That's all right with me. Any way you do.
All right, so we've got a good mix of 8th and 9th graders out there. Rylan Rashard at quarterback.
That's it. Who doesn't love Elvis Presley? This is why they loved him right here. Elvis Presley comes in the building, buddy, and the women go, wow.
Kind of the same way they do with you.
Oh, man, that's the way why he is a legend. I like to give a little shout out to my wife. She just recovered from a little surgery. So, Elise, we love you.
I will say, Joey, you were talking. There's Braden Davis up the middle.
Up the middle.
You were talking about our sports programs. Tell you what, a budding sports program is the tennis program. I heard they had 60 young kids go.
Number 23, Braden Davis on the chair for Bayou.
John Cox.
Up by number 20, Peyton
Burke. Tennis team. He's done a great job. We won 5A.
The second and five, Bayou Academy.
Last year. So look for big things out of the Bayou tennis team.
John Cox, he is up and coming. The tennis team was down in the dumps just a couple of years ago, and John Cox has turned that program around.
Oh, in around. Hey.
Ho, look out.
Misdirection.
That is your man, Parker George. He starts one way, he spins the other way, he comes back the way he started. You never can find Parker George in the crowd, and sometimes he comes out on the other end of that.
That's usually number 8, Brandon Crocker on the carry for Bayou.
Don't think that was Brandon Crocker.
He got his sixes and his eights, mister.
Well, you know, and George is kind of seeing he's playing against the Lee first team defense that, sledding's not quite as easy. You wouldn't expect it to be. Lee's not going to come. Lee doesn't want us to score. They don't care if it's our.
Hey, this is your next year's ninth grade team.
Yeah.
Trying to get a little experience on the board.
I think Braden Davis in at running back.
It's a pass.
Oh, is that a backwards pass?
Could be.
Pass incomplete.
I don't know. I think they called it down. Thank the Lord that receiver covered that ball, because they called that backwards.
Yeah, it was a backwards pass. Lost yards on the play, so it had to be backwards.
So good job by the receiver.
5 yards.
Having
backwards.
The wherewithal to cover that ball. Fourth down, under a minute to go.
Surely we'll go ahead and send Bo in to punt the ball. Or they just may eat the clock off and call timeout.
Yeah.
Yeah, the clock's running. Slowly, but running.
It can only run in seconds, Joey.
Oh, okay. Well, as I've said before, Todd, it's been a great year, man. I've enjoyed this broadcasting bit and had a lot of fun. It's always a lot of fun when you're on the winning side.
Right.
The Bayou Academy Colts have been on the winning side all year long.
A lot of these young men will go up to the high school team next year. That high school team is young now, but they're going to get another year under their belt for practice. And we wish all of those players and all our coaches the best. Coach
Jordan
Norwood's up here with us. Does a great job communicating with our coaches on the sideline, one of which is his son, formulating these offensive plays. And
absolutely. A lot of credit's got to be given. Big back Norwood. He's been around. He's a head coach over at MRA. He's been a head coach in a lot of different places. And he's helped Bayou Academy tremendously in our track team and all the work that he does on the campus. And don't forget, he's up here in this press box, and he's a great offensive coordinator. Got a lot of good plays, and we've really enjoyed him. And don't forget his son, McLeod, down on the field, who he's talking in the earpiece to. So thanks to the Norwoods.
All right. So going to punt. Monix is back deep. And I think Monix is going to get a chance to take this.
He might.
No, he's not. Good job by Griffin Peoples for covering that ball up.
Good job. Good job. Yeah, we can't give enough thanks to the coaches. You got Rodney Martin, Will Reed, of course, Coach McLeod over there.
They've all done a great job.
Great job all year long. Kids love them, and they've had a great season.
So Bayou's going to end the year with a 6-2 record, second in the district just because of that one loss to Starkville. But all in all, a great season and something to build on for these kids that are going into 10th grade, but also something to build on for these 7th and 8th graders that are going to have to shoulder the burden next year for next year's JV.
And this same football team out here, don't forget they're going to be a part of the baseball squad that D. Haynes has put together. You were mentioning John Cox. How about D. Haynes has come through for the boys and, of course, the girls softball coach.
Yep. Doing a great job. And what, you know, Wesley Aldridge is ready to get some of these football players
on the basketball
court.
And how about the talent, his brother, Peyton Aldridge, on The Voice?
Yeah. There's a handoff.
Well, that's going to do it here at Lee Stadium. The Bayou Academy Colts have taken this one 41-8.
Todd, let's see if they just walk that off. I think we will.
Any last comments you have on the season?
Well, just really, really proud of all our players, coaches, parents, cheerleaders, everybody that's been a part of this season. And thank you to Lee Academy for hosting us tonight. And just a great season all around.
Well, if you want to know what it feels like to win, ladies and gentlemen, just look at your TV set there. The Bayou Academy coach couldn't be happier. They're jumping with joy. The cheerleaders are running on the field. The parents are smiling. It's been a great night. It's been a great year. And for Todd Jeffries and Joey Mallett, we really appreciate you listening. It's been real, and it's been fun.
It's been real fun. Thank you, folks.
We're signing off for the evening.
Good night.
Bayou Academy Colt football. We'll see you again at another time.